Welcome to the video of first time doing bank reconciliation in a very specific circumstance. The circumstance that this video will address is the case when you have an old or used bank account that you've been using for many months and many years, and you also have an old or used QuickBooks file that you've also been using for many months and many years, and now you finally decided to reconcile. Well, what would you do in a case like this? You can't go all the way back to the beginning and reconcile forward. That would take years. And even if you found mistakes from many, many months ago, you would not be able to rectify them because the mistakes would be too old. So what do you do? Well, there are two phases for doing the first time bank rec in a situation like this. The first phase involves entering the ending statement balance from the statement of the month before your first real reconciliation. Then mark all the transactions dated before the current month statement as cleared. Then click Reconcile Now and enter an adjustment. Now let's back up a little and I will demonstrate the first phase, and then I'll demonstrate the other phases step by step. Let's imagine that this is your March bank statement for March of 2015. Let's also imagine that this Excel file is the bank statement of the very first month that you want to reconcile. So in our example, the bank account that this statement reflects had started in January, and we had January, February, and March transactions. The QuickBooks file that we're using also started in January and has January, February, and March's transactions. And the owner of the company feels that it's not worth the time to go back and reconcile prior months. He or she wants to start reconciling as of March of 2015. So, again, step one is to enter the ending statement balance from the statement of the month before your first real reconciliation. Well, what does that mean? Well, March is the first month of our first real reconciliation. And the balance before March would be this. The beginning balance of March would be the ending balance of February. Therefore, you should start by entering this and only entering this before you get to phase two. Banking Reconcile is the first place you would click. Now, the statement date, it might be easier for you to type it in. I'm going to click all the way back to March of 2015. And I'm going to go to February of 2015 and put February 28. Because remember, the first month we're doing is March. So in the first phase, just to prepare to do March, we put in the ending date for the February statement, and then we put in the ending balance of the February statement. And the ending balance of the February statement is the beginning balance of March. So I'm going to copy it into this field and paste it. Now, to make sure I remember that I copied it in, I'm going to mark it off as cleared by putting a light blue coloring on it. And that's what I'm going to do to the rest of the statement as I mark things off as cleared and matching in both the QuickBooks file and the bank statement. So far, we only entered one number, the ending balance of February, which is the beginning balance of March. In the first phase, you can ignore the bottom part of the first window and just click Continue. Step two in the first phase is to mark all transactions dated before the current month statement as cleared. Well, the current month statement is March, so any transaction dated before March 1, we will mark off as cleared. Now, how would we do that? There are quite a lot of them. So I think that the fastest way to mark off everything that's before the current month as cleared is to click Mark All and then only remove the check mark for the ones that are dated during the month we are reconciling. So look, all of the January and February deposits are marked, so we will simply unmark the ones in March. Same thing with the checks. All of the January and all of the February checks are all marked off, so we will simply unmark the March checks. And let's leave everything in February and before marked as cleared, and only the things in March not marked as cleared. And now we're ready for the third step of the first phase. Click Reconcile Now and enter an adjustment. So, we click Reconcile Now, and QuickBooks is warning us. It's saying, excuse me, there's still a difference of $1,161.58. Do you want to make an adjustment to your bank account for that amount? Now, in this case, we have no choice because we have absolutely no idea where that number came from. It could have been mistakes. It could have been a combination of several mistakes from months or years ago. So there's no way to know unless you go back and re-reconcile every month from the beginning of both the bank account and the QuickBooks file. So the best thing to do is just click Enter Adjustment. And now QuickBooks will adjust your cash balance for that difference. And the adjustment will go into an account that your tax accountant will handle when your tax accountant does the taxes. Click Display. And of course, just like normal, we have a reconciliation summary that tells you the important parts of the reconciliation and the detail that explains the summary. These numbers are not too meaningful because the first phase is simply preparing the file so that we can properly reconcile each month going forward. Now in the second phase, it's very simple. We reconcile normally, the way you learned in other videos. However, the difference should be zero unless there are transactions from a prior month that will clear on this current statement. And I purposely put exactly this circumstance, and you will see exactly what we have to do. If you have transactions in a prior month that are clearing on this first month statement, unfortunately, you will have to enter another similar adjustment. Don't worry, your tax accountant will know what to do with those adjustments. Once again, here's our March bank statement, and from the main menu, we click Banking, Reconcile. Now we will put in the details of the information. First, we have to put in the ending balance. So I'm just going to copy that into this field. Sometimes you might actually have to type that in. Now I'm going to find the service charge and mark that as cleared at the moment I put it in. Do not put a negative number in the service charge field. QuickBooks already knows it's negative. But we have to put the date. The date they took the service charge was March 26th of 2015. And usually people type it in, but I'm just doing a shortcut to save time. What about the interest? Well, the interest is over here. I'm going to mark it off as cleared because we're entering it now. And I'm going to copy it and paste it into the proper field. And of course, you must put the date that the bank gave you the interest. And don't forget, we're going all the way back to 2015 if you're using the sample files to follow along. Now I will click Continue, and the second bank rec window opens up. Let's match the deposits first. I scroll up. Deposit number 8 is the same in both places, so I will mark it off in QuickBooks and check it off in the bank statement, or vice versa. Let's see, what other deposits? How about deposit 9? Looks to me like deposit number 8 and deposit number 9 are the only positive numbers in this bank statement. So I'll mark it off and click the check mark here. But what about deposit number 10? Do not touch deposit number 10. Deposit number 10 is an outstanding deposit, and we learned in previous videos, if something did not clear the bank, do not mark it off. Do not click on it. As long as you leave it alone, it will have no effect on the bank reconciliation process. Now notice the difference is getting closer and closer to zero. Now as we do the checks, you will see something very interesting. Let's start up at the top. I happen to know that check number 30 and 31 are the same in both places. So I'm going to mark them off rather quickly. I happen to know check number 32 is the same in both places. Okay, so I'm going to mark it off. Now, wait a minute. Check number 16 was written in a previous month. But check number 16 is not here during March. Well, why is that? Check number 16 was already marked as cleared when we did phase 1. Check number 16 was already marked off as cleared, and therefore, we can't enter it. We can't enter it because it was already entered. We can't mark it as cleared because it was already cleared during phase 1. So what should we do? Let's leave it alone, and you'll see at the end what we need to do about checks in the previous month that cleared this month. Now, we continue with check number 33, and I happen to know that check number 33 is the same in both places. Okay, what else? I happen to know that check number 37 is also the same in both places. So, as you can see, in the QuickBooks file, the checks are in numeric order. In the bank statement, they will not always be in numeric order because they will clear on different dates. And the banks usually put the checks in the order in which they cleared, not check number order and not date written. Check number 29. Well, that's interesting. Wait a minute. Check number 29 is obviously from a previous month. And as you can see, check number 29 is not during March, or it would be listed here. Well, what do we do? That's our second example of a check written in a previous month that cleared in this month. We cannot enter it because it was already entered in QuickBooks in a previous month. We cannot mark it as cleared because we already cleared it in phase 1. So for now, we leave it alone, and you will see how we handle that at the end. However, checks number 35 and 36 are both the same in both places, and I happen to know check 34 and 38 are the same in both places. See, 34, 38, now we're getting very close to the end. Let's look very closely. Oh, there's only one more check that we could possibly mark off. Check number 40. So we mark off in the statement and we mark it off here. Now let's stop for a moment. We have marked off everything except the transactions at the end of March that will clear in the next month. Actually, 39, I think we accidentally... Is 39 up here? No, 39 is an outstanding check. So, we have marked off everything except the deposits in transit and the outstanding checks that were written at the end of March, which is the first month that we're doing this reconciliation. Why doesn't the difference equal zero? Well, if you look at the difference, you will notice that the difference is $645.49. And if you remember, we had two checks that we did not mark off as cleared because they were written in a previous month, entered in a previous month, and cleared in a previous month. Well, I'm going to tell you something interesting. Those two checks add up to the $645.49. The two checks that were written in a previous month, that were recorded in a previous month into QuickBooks, and we already cleared in phase one, only those two are the things causing the amount of difference between the bank statement and the QuickBooks file. There's nothing we can do about it because they're already entered and they're already marked as cleared. So the only thing we can do now is allow QuickBooks to enter another adjustment. We click Reconcile now, and QuickBooks warns us that there's a discrepancy of $645.49. And again, we already know that's because these two checks were both recorded and marked as cleared in a previous period. So the only thing we can do is allow QuickBooks to enter an adjustment. But remember, those two things must be the only difference. Those two things must add up to the difference. If they don't, it means you have a mistake somewhere on your first month's bank rec. So let's go ahead and enter the adjustment. Click display for the two transactions. And every future reconciliation should be fine, unless, of course, this happens again. Unless, of course, there's another check back from January and February that winds up clearing in the month that you're working on. If that's the case, you have no choice but to enter an adjustment. And don't worry about the adjustments you record. Your tax accountant will know how to handle them when he or she does your taxes.